Welcome to class Programming and Problem Solving. We will discuss today about object-oriented programming. In it, we will see how to implement object-oriented programming features. Let's discuss about features of object-oriented programming. We will see object-oriented programming having following features: class, object, methods, inheritance, polymorphism, data encapsulation, and data hiding. Now, class. Actually, almost every language has some basic data types such as integer, float, long, and so on. But not all real world objects can be represented using these built-in data types. Therefore, object-oriented programming specifically designed to solve these real-world problems. It allows its user to create user-defined data type in the form of class. A class is used to describe something in the world, such as occurrences, things, external entities, and so on. A class also provides a template or blueprint that describes the structure and behavior of set of similar objects. We can create multiple objects for the same class. So, in other words, class is also called collection of objects. Basically, when we create object, data type or type of that object is name of class. So, class is also called as user-defined data type. So, we will see one example of student class. So here I have created class with the name student. This class is having data like one variable having value equal to 100, one more variable having value equal to 200. Here I created object of that class, and these are the way with which I can access the data of the class. You can see here I access data by using class name, and I access data by using object name. So whatever data I have defined in the class is common to class as well as object. So data in the class is shared by class and object. This sentence will not true for all data of the class, only for the specific data. So this is a keyword class, which is very important while declaring class. Name of class, naming conventions in Python must be followed. This is called data of class, which is shared by class and object. The line actually tells you how you are creating object, and the remaining things are access to class data outside class by using object and class name. We will see an example directly on a programming console about writing class. So you see, as we see, defining class starts with a keyword class. Then we have to give name for the class, opening bracket, closing bracket, followed by colon. Once we press enter, we are defining data for the class inside class. So data is two variables, a equal to 100, b equal to 400. That is the sufficient data for the class. Now when I want to access this data outside class, I cannot access it directly. Suppose I am writing print a. We'll see what kind of error is there. See, error is name A is not defined. This is the reason that the variable you are trying to print outside class is not a member of class. See, the member of class is A, but it is not a way to print it outside class. Now see, I will make a little change, student.a. So I am trying to print a variable which is member of class student. When we run it, we will get it. So to access data of class outside class, we need to write class name dot value, that variable name. Again, one more method is there to access data outside class by creating object. So objects are created with the line, say name of object is equal to class name. So object is created, and you can also access data of class by using object. See here, 200 is printed where I have written print s dot b. So this is the way of declaring class and accessing members outside class. Remember, whatever members that we are defining in class are the property of class. That is not property of outside program. We can define same name variables outside class, which are not member of class. So when we are writing class, remember to write this keyword class, the name of class, and then define members in the class. Class can have multiple types of members. In this class, I have defined only variables. Instead, I can define some functions as well. So define name of function, say display. I will write some data for display, print in display function. This can be a class which contains two types of data, two variables and one function. The rule is same to access this data. I can call this function by writing class name student.display. The reason here, display is member of class student. When we call only display function, see here I commented that normal class function call, and here I am calling this display function, and I have this defined display function inside class. When I will run it, again it will say name display is not defined. Because whenever we are writing independent display function, Python will search this function outside class, and outside class this function is not defined. But whenever we are writing student.display, Python will search this display function inside class, and this display function is there. So when we run it, it will display output. So this is all about the class in Python. Now another feature in object-oriented programming that we will learn today with the programming is object. So object is called as an instance of class. You can also relate it as a representative of a class. Remember, we are having class of 60 students. So every time we cannot take that class outside the program. So instead of that, we can take instance of that class, representative of that class outside the class. And with that object, it is possible to access members of class. So according to previous example, if we say FE1 class or FE2 class, then all the students of that class are nothing but object of that class. Hence, again it is proved that class can have multiple instances, class can have multiple objects, and class is a collection of objects. Now here, the speciality of object is object has some data and functions associated with it. Means in a class, there can be two types of attributes, two types of data. Some data belongs to only class, some data belongs to only object, and some data belongs to both. So there are certain data which only object can access, not class name can access. And there is some data which can be accessed by only using class name, not by using object. The function stores normally the functions associated with objects stores the data in variables and respond to the message which it receives from the other objects. So one object can communicate with other object with the help of functions. Actually, when we think about the difference between class and object, a class is a logical structure where object is a physical actuality. The same example here with which I have written two extra functions apart from previous examples. So this is the line which is creating object. So here I am calling function, one function I call with class name and another function I call with object name. The reason, the display function is a property of class, whereas show function is a property of object. How to identify this? So the basic identification depends upon this self argument. So any function which we are defining inside class having self argument, it becomes property of object. So we have to call that function only by using object. And if any function inside class, say this display function, which will not have self argument, it can have other arguments, but if it is not having self argument, then that becomes property of class. So only class can call this function, not the object. And the remaining thing, like these variables, are the shared data of class and object. We will see examples. So this is called as class function. Basically, display is called as class function, and show is called object function. The reason display is called by class only, and this show function is called by object. We'll see one example of creating object and accessing methods of object. Again, we will write same class, class student, and inside class student we will define two methods. First method is display. Now here in display I am not writing any argument. Now you can check, I have not written one argument, which is having name self. So by default it will become class function. So here I am writing RM class function. In the same class I am defining one more method, define show, and it is having argument with the name self. So whenever one function in a class is having self name argument, it becomes object property. Then I will write print rm object function. Now we will try to access these two outside class. Before that we will create object. Now creating object, a name equal to class name. So we have created object with capital S. Now I will call display function with class name student.display, and we will check the output. Here we are getting output I am class function. Now I will call show function with class name. I will call student.show with class name. When I will run it, I am taking, see the error, show missing one required positional argument self. So whenever you want to call this show using class name, this should not contain any argument having name self. So the functions are having argument self should be called by object only. So I will write here object name s.show, and see I am getting, I am object function. So this is the way we discussed before, that in a class there can be two types of attributes, class attribute and object attribute. And the way we are identifying, the self name attributes are object attributes, and without self name attributes are class attributes. Normally this attribute separation is based for the functions only. So this display is called as class method, and this show is called as object method. There are some other variables that can be accessed by both. So creating object is mandatory whenever we are having object methods in the class, until and unless we will not have access to it. So this is all about class and object. In next session we will learn about inheritance. Thank you.